We're going to look at various parts of biolab safety, and there are many rules and regulations that we really need to catch up on. First off, as far as clothing goes, no open-toed shoes. You wouldn't believe what's on the floor here. We ask you not to wear shorts or expensive clothes to the lab. We will use things that will stain clothing. And if you've got shorts, you're sitting on a chair that we don't know what's on it. We have gloves for anyone who chooses to use them. No eating, drinking, applying cosmetics in the lab. There is a simple reason for this. This is a biolab with all sorts of material you do not want to put in your mouth or on your skin. Turn off the Bunsen burner when not in use. This is because we don't want to set anybody on fire. Report any spill or injury, no matter how small, to the instructor immediately. The reason is, we know how to clean things up, and normally we can do a fairly good job of it. And we want to contain these things very quickly. Security must be called for all emergency. This includes things as simple as a paper cut. This protects you and allows for medical treatment if necessary. MSDS sheet, manufacturer safety data sheets, are available to anybody upon request. Looking at the front of the room, we can observe all sorts of safety equipment. First is the fire blanket. Stop, drop, and roll. Next is the fire extinguisher. Point at the base of the fire, pull the pin, and squeeze the trigger. Then we have the first aid kit. Remember, if you get injured, I'm going to call security. We are not medical staff, and hopefully someone who is an EMT or nurse will be able to apply first aid. Next, we have the eye wash. It is not a water fountain. If you spill something in your eyes, this will help cleanse the eye. Then we have the chemical shower. Should you spill something all over, this shower is used to dilute the material. This part of the room contains the emergency electrical cutoff valve in case of an electrical emergency. Next to it is a box with several valves. The blue one is the emergency gas cutoff. Cut off is when the lever is perpendicular to the pipe. Parallel to the pipe indicates the gas is on. Now, upon entering the lab, there are several things you want to do. First, place all extra material, including turned off electronics, in the designated area that's in the front of the classroom. We don't want you taking stuff all over the classroom. Your lab books, pens, pencils should be the only objects at the lab bench. Disinfect the bench top with the detergent solution that we have there. That is to make sure that it's clean from the last time there was a lab. Wash your hands thoroughly. Before leaving the lab, dispose of all refuse in the proper container. Clear the bench and sink areas. Push the stools back under the table. And this is done so that you don't create a trip hazard for everyone else. Disinfect the bench top and then wash your hands thoroughly. So anytime you're going to leave, you should wash your hands, and this is to cut down on contamination from everywhere. When we look at biological hazard waste, we will be dealing with biohazard waste. This includes culture plates, gloves, swabs, and any item that came in contact with biological material. However, not glassware and not paper towel. Broken glass goes in the big paper box. Other material goes in the trash can, and that includes paper towels from hand washing, sterile wrappers, parafilm. You do not put gloves in the trash can. With cultures, we're going to ask you to treat everything as pathogenic. Nothing we're going to use in this class is supposed to be hazardous to anybody. However, if you are immunocompromised, if you have a cut, if you have something like that, it could affect and allow something that normally isn't pathogenic to give you some sort of infection. Therefore, we want to be very careful and treat everything as pathogenic. Now we're going to reiterate. Do everything safely and you should have an excellent time in biolab. And we want you to be as safe as possible.